Hello everyone. Magnet is a slightly fascinating word for children. And here we are different kinds of magnets today. It was naturally obtained from a substance called magnetite. But nowadays, different kinds of magnets have been made. Out of which we have U-shaped magnet, this is disc magnet or button magnet, ring magnet, compass needle, bar magnet. Let's begin with the bar magnet. That what are the different type of magnetic field lines and how does it change? For this thing, I have taken a bar magnet and placed here. Now I have this iron filling. Iron filling, when I take the iron filling and sprinkle gently here around it, these field lines will be formed. I'm not doing it, but you will observe finally, you can see that field lines are going and they are sticking towards the poles. Their density is slightly more near the poles. And they are forming a particular pattern. They are forming a circular pattern near this. These are the field lines. And here, this is a cluster of pole lines. So here, when we define it, describe it, you can see that these are the two poles of the magnet. And these field lines are tending to make close curves. Actually, they emerge from North Pole, making a closed curve and enter to the South Pole. Here, comparatively, the amount of magnetic iron fillings is more, which shows that magnetic field strength will be more here. At this portion, there are no field lines. There are no iron fillings attached to it because the field line is here. The field is minimum. So pole strength is maximum at the poles and it is minimum here. Actually, there is a drawback of this pattern that we are getting the south and north pole, but there are no directions of the magnetic field lines. To trace the direction of magnetic field lines, we have another device, compass needle. Compass needle is also a magnet, but it is light in weight and it is pivoted at the stand so that it can rotate freely. So when I place this near the magnet, it has pointed to a particular direction. This is the North Pole and I mark the dot here and then one dot here. Then I place it here, it has turned. You can see it has turned on its own. And then I mark the another pointer here. Then I place it here. Wait for it to settle. And then mark the another point here. Then I gently move it, it has shifted. Mark the point here and then I bring it closer, it has come to this side. So ultimately, if I'm going to join these points, they will ultimately make a close curve. And while pointing it out, I can see that this pole is North Pole and it is entering to this side. Here, when I place it, it is emerging out. Okay, so this is the North Pole, this is the South Pole. So the field lines are emerging this side. And this pole is going to be the North Pole and this is going to be the South Pole. If we repeat it for the other sides, we will get the magnetic field line pattern for the magnet that will be like this. Here, this way, and then straight line. So if we repeat this experiment using the compass needle, we'll get the magnetic field lines. North Pole, the field lines will always emerge and they will enter to the South Pole. These are the field lines. Make sure when you're drawing these lines, they should not intersect. They should not cut each other. And there should be a closed curve. If we want to make a bigger, then it will form here. So that's why we have left it here. Now let's see the poles of this is a U-shaped magnet and when I place it here and sprinkle the iron fillings, you can see I'm sprinkling it here also, but they are more clustered here at this point because these two are the poles and the field lines are making a closed curve. They are moving through this side and then going to this side and then going to this side, so they are making closed curve. And in order to do that, they remain here. When you want to store these, you can see that these are forming the closed curves. I think you can see it here. They are forming the closed curves. Okay. Now, when we want to store, we always suggested that when we store these, we should place iron plate here so that the field lines pass through this plate and they are captured here in this closed periphery. They don't go out. Otherwise, they are maybe spoiling other devices placed. And that is why when the bar magnet is stored, bar magnet is always stored such a way that their opposite poles are towards each other and the plastic casing is placed here and then this here. Actually, it has a purpose. Because when the magnetic field, these magnets are stored here in the pairs, the field line will emerge from north and enter to south. And if you place this magnetic material here, the movement of the field lines will be much easier. They will not go here and there. And they are not going to spoil any other device placed nearby. So that's providing the direct path. Second thing, we place a plastic here. Why can't we take iron here? Because if we take iron here, the field lines will directly pass from here. And the poles of the magnet will shift. We want the magnetic field lines to complete their path. We don't want them to take a shortcut. Because if they are going to take a shortcut from here, these poles will shift. So there should be a closed curve, but taking their own path. So here we have taken the magnetic material, but here we have taken the non-magnetic material. Thank you.